divide a piece of writing into a sentence. So I've said it's a sign. Such as, comma, full stop, question mark, speech mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, used to divide a piece of writing in a sentence. So I've said a sign such as a comma, full stop, question mark, speech mark, exclamation mark, used to divide a piece of writing in sentences. So this punctuation mark divides a piece of writing in sentences. So today, boys and girls, we are going to look at this one by one. We'll look at how to use a comma, how to use a full stop, how to use a speech mark, how to use exclamation mark, and how to use the capital letters. We have about 14 punctuation marks, but today we're going to look at just few punctuation marks. So I'll start with the full stop. This is a sign of a full stop. So if I may ask a question, how do we use a full stop? How do we use a full stop? And this is a sign of a full stop. So if you have got any question, boys and girls, you can text me on this line, 0970703139. Okay, we use a full stop to mark the end of a sentence. We use a full stop to mark the end of a sentence. If a sentence has ended, we always use a full stop. So we use a full stop to mark the end of a sentence. We use a full stop to mark the end of a sentence. So I'm saying a full stop is used to mark the end of a sentence. So I've said a full stop is used to mark the end of a sentence. If a sentence has come to an end, we always use a full stop. It's used to mark the end of a sentence. Okay, let me give you examples on how you can use a full stop. Full stop. Since you have said it's used to mark the end of the sentence. So, for example, you can say, let's look at this example on the board. Lusaka is a capital city of Zambia. Lusaka is a capital city of Zambia. So this sentence has come to an end. We are supposed to put a full stop. Since we have said it's used to mark the end of the sentence. So Lusaka is a capital city of Zambia. Of course, when starting, you're supposed to always start with a capital letter. So Lusaka is a capital city of, meaning the sentence has come to an end. The other example which I can give you is okay, let's go to another example. Let's look at how to use a question mark. How to use a question mark. Yeah, from looking at it, full stop. Let's now look at it, how you use a question mark. Boys and girls, if you have got any question, you can still text me on the line which are scrolling on your screen, 0970-7039-3139. Okay, let's look at how to use a question mark. If I may ask, boys and girls, how do you use a question mark? How do you use a question mark? Okay, the sign is this one. This is a sign of a question mark. This is a sign of a question mark. Okay, the question mark is used at the end of any question. A question mark is used at the end of any question. If you're asking someone a question, we always use a question mark. For example, what is your name? Where are you going? Those are questions. So at the end, we put a question. Since you have said it's used to mark the question. So we are saying a question mark that is used to, it's used to at the end of the sentence. So it's saying is used at the end of a question. So we are saying question mark is used at the end of a question. At the end of any question, boys and girls, we are supposed to use a question mark. At the end of any question, you're supposed to use a question mark. For example, why are you crying? That's a question you're supposed to... Let me give you some example. Examples on how to use a question mark. For example, where are you going? Where are you going? So if you look at this sentence, boys and girls, this is a question. We are supposed to use a question mark. Where are you going? It's a question. So at the end of this sentence, boys and girls, we are supposed to put a question mark. The other example that I can give you is, let's look at this sentence, boys and girls. Have you had your breakfast? Someone is asking, have you had your breakfast? So here is a question. We're supposed to put a question mark at the end of this sentence. Have you had your breakfast? So we have said we use a question mark at the end of any question. So I've given you some examples here. Where are you going? Have you had your breakfast? I hope you're following what I'm explaining here, because at the end of this lesson, I'm going to give you an exercise that you're supposed to do. I'll give an activity. So I've said we are looking at punctuation mark, and I've said it's a sign such as comma, full stop, question mark, speech mark, explanation mark, used to divide a piece of writing in sentences. So this punctuation mark divides a piece of writing in sentences. We have looked at full stop, and I've said it's used to end the mark. It's used to end of a sentence. It's used to mark the end of a sentence. For example, Lusaka is the capital city of Zambia. It has come to an end. We were supposed to put a full stop. We have also looked at how to use a question mark, And I've said this used to end, it's used at the end of a question, and I've given you some examples. Where are you going? You add a question mark because it's a question someone is asking. Have you had your breakfast? This is your question as well. No wonder I've put a question mark. Boys and girls, if you've got any question, can still text on this line which are scrolling on your screen, which is 0970703139. Okay, let's continue. Our next mark that we're going to look at is a comma. We have 14 punctuation marks, but for today, we just look at few marks. So let's look at how to use a comma. This is a sign of a comma. That's a sign of a comma. If I may ask, boys and girls, how do you use a comma? How do you use a comma? And that's a sign. How do you use a comma? So a comma is used to separate things. It's used to separate things in a list. A comma is used to separate things in a list. A comma is used to separate things in a list. So I'm saying comma is used to separate things in a list. So I've said a comma is used to separate things in a list. This one is used to separate things in a list. If you're listing something, we are supposed to use a comma because you're saying it's used to separate things in a list. So if you're listing something, you're supposed to use a comma. Let me give you some examples, boys and girls, on how you can use a comma since you have said it's used to separate things in a list. For example, let me give you two examples so that you see how you can use a comma. For example, the flag. The flag was red . Let's look at that example. The flag was red, blue, and white. The flag was red, blue, and white. And we have said it's used to separate things in a list. So here we are saying the flag was red, blue, and white. They have listed some colors of the flag. Red, blue, and white. So here you're going to put a comma to separate this list, and at the end of the sentence we're going to put a full stop, because at the beginning we said a full stop is used to mark the end of a sentence. This has come to an end, we put a full stop. So now to read, the flag was red, blue, and black. Let me give you the other example on how you can use a comma. I went to the market and bought bananas, apples, boys and girls, let's look at this sentence on the board, the other example that we have. I went to the market and bought bananas, apples, oranges, and grapes. So we have said a comma is used to separate things in a list. So here, I went to the market and bought these things. So you're supposed to separate this list. Bought bananas, comma, apples, comma, oranges and grapes. At the end of the sentence, you put a full stop. So now to read, I went to the market and bought bananas, apples, oranges and grapes. To read, I went to the market and bought bananas, oranges, apples, oranges and grapes. Okay, let us look at another mark that we have. Let's look at how we can use how do we use the capital letters. It's also another mark that we have under punctuation. So how do you use capital letters? How do you use this? These capital letters. So capital letters are used at the beginning of any sentence. If you can see, all the sentences are starting with the capital letters. So capital letters are used at the beginning of any sentence, or if a sentence has come to an end, or when you're using it, proper noun. So all proper nouns supposed to start with the capital letters. For example, a name of a person, say proper noun, supposed to start with a capital letter. A name of a district, a name of a river, a name of a province, a name of a person. So all those are supposed to start with the capital letters, or at the beginning of any sentence. You're supposed to use a capital letter. For example, name of a person, like my name, Annie. So this is a name of a person, it's a proper noun. So we're not supposed to start with a small letter. You can't write this name like this. This is wrong. So you're supposed to always start with a capital letter. A name, for example, Lusaka, proper noun. Another example I can give, maybe I say Kafue, and so on. So these are proper nouns. Always start with a capital letter, or at the beginning of a sentence, always start with a capital letter. So capital letters are used at the beginning of a sentence, or when you're, or proper nouns, or all proper nouns start with a capital letters. So you have looked at full stop, question mark, comma, capital letters. Boys and girls, if you've got any question, you can text me on this line 0970703139. Got any question, you can text me on this line. Okay, let's continue, boys and girls. Let us now look at how you can use the speech mark. Speech mark. Or quotation mark. Speech mark or quotation mark. Speech mark or quotation mark. How do you use this? How do you use a speech mark? How do you use this one is used to mark a direct speech. This one is used to mark a direct speech. Things that are being spoken by someone. Things being spoken by someone. So you're saying it marks a direct speech. It marks a direct speech. And these are the signs of speech mark or quotation mark. So this one it marks a direct speech. This one marks a direct speech. For example, how are you? She Me. So let us look at this sentence. How are you? She asked me. So you're saying speech marks a direct speech. So there you're supposed to, of course, these are the words which are being spoken by someone. It's a direct. These are the words that are spoken by someone. How are you? She was asking someone, how are you? So you put speech marks here to show that these are the words being spoken by someone. Then here we put a comma. At the end we put a full stop. At the end we put a full stop. How are you? She asked me. So these were the words which were being spoken. This person was asking, how are you? She asked me. Another question of how you can use a speech mark is, let us look at this sentence on the board, boys and girls. The grade 6 pupils are going to Livingstone, said Mr. Peary. And we said speech marks a direct speech, word being spoken by someone. So if you look at this, which word were being spoken? The grade 6 pupils are going to Livingstone, said Mr. Peary. So Mr. Peary said these words that the grade 6 pupils are going to Livingstone. So where do we put the speech marks? Where do we put the speech marks? We'll put here at the beginning, because these were the words which were spoken by Mr. Peary. He said the grade 6 pupils are going to Livingstone. Here we put a comma. At the end we put a full stop. So you have said speech marks a direct speech. And I've said, I've given you two examples. You have got this one. The first one is this one. How are you? So I said these were the words which were being spoken. Number two, I've said the grade 6 pupils are going to Livingstone, said Mr. Peary. So I've said these were the words which were being spoken by Mr. Peary. Okay, boys and girls, you have looked at full stop, question mark, comma, capital letters, and speech mark. Got any question, boys and girls? Can text me on the line which is showing on your screen, which is 0970703139. Let me just check if there are any questions before I proceed. Okay, seems don't have any question. Let us look at another map. I hope you have copied what was on the board. Let us look at how you can use the exclamation mark. How do we use the exclamation mark? So I'm saying how do you use the exclamation mark? How are you supposed to use this? How do you, and this is a sign. That's a sign of exclamation mark. That's a sign of exclamation mark. How do you use this? How do we use this? This is used after a sentence or a word. Exclamation mark is used after a sentence or a word that expresses surprise, if you're surprised, hunger, or excitement. For example, excited, we use the exclamation mark. Wow! Or if you're surprised of something, we use a exclamation mark. So I've said it's used after a sentence or a word. It's used after a sentence or a word that expresses surprise, surprise, hunger, or excitement. So that's a sign of an exclamation mark. So this one is used. Exclamation mark is used after a sentence. Exclamation mark is used after a sentence or word that expresses surprise, hunger, or excitement. So saying it's used after a sentence or word that expresses surprise, hunger, or excitement. So we have said it's used after a sentence or a word that expresses surprise, hunger, or excitement. For example, maybe you're surprised or hunger, upset, or we are excited. You use the exclamation mark. Let me give you examples on how you can use this exclamation mark. Examples on how you can use the exclamation mark. Since you have said it's used after a sentence or a word that expresses surprise, hunger, or excitement. For example, we have got this example on the board, boys and girls. Don't pick that. Don't pick that. Where do we put the exclamation mark there? Don't pick that. Put the exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. Don't pick that. Don't pick that. We put the exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. Another example on how you can use the exclamation mark is, for example, let me give you this example. Let us look at this example, boys and girls. What a beautiful dress. What a beautiful dress. So here we are supposed to put exclamation mark. Where do we put the exclamation mark here, boys and girls? What a beautiful dress. So put exclamation mark at the end. Of course, you are supposed to start with a capital letter. I said you always start with a capital letter at the beginning of any sentence. So exclamation mark is used after a sentence or a word that expresses hunger, surprise, or excitement. And I've given you two examples. I've got don't pick that. What a beautiful dress. Okay, let's look at how you can use the colony. And this is a sign of colony. These are colony. How do we use these colons? So a colony sometimes introduces a series or list to describe some new information after a complete sentence. So I've said colony sometimes introduces a series or list to describe some new information after a complete sentence. So I've said colony sometimes. Colony sometimes. Introduce. A series. Siri, or list to describe some new information. After a complete sentence, So I'm saying, boys and girls, a colony sometimes introduces a series or list to describe some new information after a complete sentence. For example, let us look at how we can use this colony in a sentence. I'm going to give you an example. The fruit seller had 3 fruit: bananas. The fruit seller had 3 fruit: bananas, bananas, apples, and oranges. The fruit seller had 3 fruit: bananas, apples, and oranges. So we have said a colony introduces a series or list to describe some new information after a complete sentence. So the fruit seller had 3 fruits. So here, this sentence has come to an end here. We put a colony there. The fruit seller had 3 fruit. So this would say add bananas, apples, and oranges. At the end, we put a full stop. So this is how we use colonies. It's used to describe some new information after a complete sentence. Boys and girls, today we've looked at punctuation mark, we've talked about full stop, we've talked about exclamation mark, we've talked about commas, we have talked about capital letters, speech mark, exclamation mark, and we've also talked about colonies. Once again, if you've got any question, boys and girls, this is grade 6 class with me, Mrs. Kantoma. You can text me on this line, 0970-703139. If you've got any question, boys and girls, you can text me on that line. So I hope you have taken note of whatever we have discussed today. And I said at the end of this lesson, I'm going to give an activity which I expect you to give me correct answers. I hope it's clear. Let me just give you an exercise that you're supposed to do at home. So you're supposed to try this exercise that I'm going to give you. You can start taking note. You can write this exercise on the board. Use suitable use suitable punctuation mark in the following sentences. So I'm going to give you some sentences that you're supposed to punctuate, where you'll be using any of colonies, full stops, question mark. So the first question is, what supposed to be, where are you going next weekend? Where are you going next weekend? So there, boys and girls, should look at, should use a suitable which punctuation suits this question. If you read this question, where are you going next weekend? You should punctuate. Number two, the second question is, I like playing with my friends. I like playing with my friends Sandy, Mary, and Jane. So boys and girls, there should use a suitable punctuation mark. I like playing with my friend Sandy, Mary, and Jane. You look for a suitable punctuation that you're going to use here. The third one reads, Annie said, come here. So the third question reads, Annie said, come here. Which punctuation? So even this one, look for a suitable punctuation mark. Which one are you going to use? Annie said, come here. And the last question reads, John went to the market and bought Okay, boys and girls, the last question reads, John went to the market and bought bananas, apples, lemons, and oranges. So I expect you to answer these questions. You use a suitable punctuation mark in the following sentences. So number one reads, where are you going next weekend? I like playing with my friends, Sandy, Mary, and Jen. Number three, Annie said, come here. Number four, John went to the market and bought bananas, apples, lemons, and oranges. So boys and girls, today we have looked at a punctuation mark. I hope you have understood. Let me just check if there are any questions. Nadine says, start giving me answers. You should give me answers when you meet next. Yes, so you should answer. I've just given you 4 questions for today. You can copy these questions and answer them. I'm still waiting for questions. If there are any questions, boys and girls, can SMS me on 0970-703139. And the GMF online learning are still available. If you want to be part and parcel of the learning, you can still call on the line which is screen on your screen, which is 0970-703139. This was a grade 6 class and we looked at a punctuation mark. It seems we don't have any questions. Let me just do the recap of today's lesson. We started with the full stop. I said it's used to mark the end of the sentence. Exclamation marks used after a sentence or a word that expresses hunger, excitement, and I gave some examples. So even when answering these questions, you can just go on the example that I was giving. I'm sure everyone will get this question correct. We also looked at question mark and we said it's used at the end of a question. If you're asking a question, you use a question mark. We also looked at capital letters and I said capital letters are used on start when you are starting a question, you always use a question mark or any proper noun. And I said proper nouns can be name of a person, a place, a province, a city, a country. We always use a capital letter. I also looked at speech mark. I've said this is a direct speech. When the words which are being spoken by someone, we use a speech mark. We also looked at commas and we said it's used to separate things in a list. If you have listed things and you want to separate them, we use a comma, boys and girls. We also looked at colony and we said this one is used to describe some new information after a complete sentence. And I gave you this example. So I hope you have copied the questions which are on the board. I'm still waiting for questions. It seems we don't have any question. I hope we have understood the lesson for today. This was the grade 6 class, English language, with me, Mrs. Annie Kantoma, until we meet again.
Of crops that will grow in Zambia and the life.
Look at the algebraic expression.